Even though I'm not seeing what's going on in the studio, but yes, we're gonna keep this popping. Yes, so I've got with me a super duper personality, and he goes by the name Blackbeard. What's good?
Hey, I'm good. What's up? What's happening?
I'm blessed, man. Good to have you in the studio, and I'm sure this is a special edition because, man, it's just me and you in the studio. Yeah, usually, nice. I have some beautiful girls for you, but I don't know where they are today.
I'm married, you know.
I mean, are you carried and go?
I'm married, dude.
Oh, not true. Hey, but you know me now. God knows me, we know admire now.
Normally.
You know the admire.
Nobody. Of course not.
Speaking of that, you have a very, you know, sweet relationship with your wife, by the way. Congratulations on being married. Yeah. So I saw a video that went viral of you and your wife, and when you put her on the hot stove, I'm sure a lot of people didn't see a lot of people have seen that video and they're like, oh, the love went wrong and all. Tell us about that video real quick.
Okay, I know most of you are thinking about the video, like it's super real and all that, but it's just a joke. It's just a joke, a funny, real joke, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how we all started about the video, but we just thought about something and just came up, you know, ideas and all that came up, and we did. And we had about 5 different shots of the video and got that one. I had something different, but we got that one, like, okay, let's try this.
Is your wife an actress or something? Because that was super real. The way she jumped down, like, even me, I felt the pain for her, like, you know that feeling that everybody just go, what just happened there? That was dope. All right, so before we even go on, let me introduce you to the world. So Blackbeard is a Nigerian-based producer, an artist known for his hip-hop influenced Afrobeat sound. Blackbeard grew up in Warri. After high school, he relocated to Port Harcourt, where he studied civil engineering at the University of Port Harcourt. Basing himself there, in 2016, he relocated to Lagos. And he launched his musical career in 2018 with a self-acclaimed street hit single, I want him fresh. And with the King of the South, and he did a song with the King of the South, Young Six, on the track Better Days. Mm-hmm. The single caught on, and more high-profile recordings followed, including Wine Up, featuring Damien Crane, which also performed well. Blackbeard dropped Dobale, featuring Mogul, my favorite, by the way. Mm-hmm. And he dropped his first single of the year, Vanessa. Yep. And of course, what's that song dedicated to someone special?
Well, of course, dedicated to my wife.
Is her name Vanessa?
No, her name is Irene.
Oh, okay.
So I wrote that song during the pandemic, 2020. I didn't know I'm going to shoot the video with her. I knew people don't know about that. Yeah. I didn't know I'm going to shoot the video with her. So I wrote the song, and somehow everything, of course, she inspired me to write a song. Mm. But the name of the song is Vanessa. Mm. But it's actually for her. So I didn't choose her name. Yeah.
So how did you guys meet? Because you seem to have like a very super.
I met in Port Harcourt, my street in Port Harcourt, 2012. Mm. Just saw her on the street and just friends and all that. Just talk all day on the phone. We hardly see physically, just talk on the phone.
At what point did you know this is the woman I'm going to marry?
First time I met her, I just like, you know, she's so beautiful. She's just different, you know, and I like, you know, I'm going to keep pushing for this one. She's going to be my friend. Just put it out there. And after my university, immediately I finished university, I still kept in touch. We still kept in touch, although we're distant for a while, but 2016, 2017, you know what? She's the one. I'm just going to take my time and, you know, be cool with her. So 2016, 2017, I knew she was.
I'm sure the people are wondering, man, we need to see this babe we're talking about. But you guys, calm down, yeah? We know why we do it on this show. We still have to analyze the big stories for you, because what's tea time without analyzing the big story? And yes, I have a super duper co-anchor and a guest, man, 2-in-1. I've never had that before on this show. You're the first person that will be my co-anchor and be a guest at the same time. So we'll be talking about your life, but first off, let's jump on the show and analyze some big stories, right? Mm-hmm. All right, so the first story of the day is a Nigerian singer DMW boss Davido, who has reacted to the mind-blowing news that his music video has hit 200 million views on YouTube. He wrote, "I remember me and Kid Dominance making this record as a joke. Well, this said nothing to laugh at. God is good, and thanks to all of you for supporting me ever since the start. I appreciate every single one of you, single one of you." And yes, and that's for Fall, mm-hmm. Fall on You. Mm-hmm. What you think, man? Like, he said he created that song being a joke. You know, there's songs that you just go into the studio and it's like, oh, it's all vibe, and they end up being the big ones. Do you have such songs?
Yeah, yeah, it happens. It happens a lot. I think most of the songs that blue, or most of the songs that's like great vibe, that's very, very like different, is songs that you didn't really put all your effort in, and you know, it just happens. It just happens. That's why I see it. So if a saying four was just like a joke or something, it came out nice. Trust me, it came out nice.
200 million views, though. Mm-hmm. If you have a song that has 200 million mm-hmm. views on YouTube, mm-hmm. being the professional on this table, being, what is the monetary value of 200 million views?
I can't do the calculation right now, but it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money on YouTube, you know. YouTube pays a lot of money. Like, you can calculate 200 million times, probably maybe $0.004, you know. That's a lot of money.
Wow, that's a lot of money. So Baba is cashing out normally from his music, and he's still cashing out from YouTube alone. Now, which one of your songs, personally, would you say, man, I went into the studio with this song, it was just a vibe, like, okay, let's just do this. And it's like, watch all your guys and say, oh, man, that jam is a jam. What song is that for you?
I'll say Dobale.
Dobale. Obviously, Dobale. Dobale is like something that you guys are just having fun, you know. And also, maybe you're not married then. Dobale, are you married?
I wasn't married.
It's not like it's something that you're still in the world. Anyways, let's move on to the next story. So, controversial activist shared a post on his Instagram page stating that many Nollywood actresses are guilty of having another man's children for their husbands. He revealed that if a DNA test is to be conducted on each of their children, they will have to leave their marriages. According to him, he wrote, if they do DNA tests for Nollywood, many actresses go wrong come out for their marriage. When 80% Pekin, no be their husband own. That's Maduagu, the, you know, gay activist, the guy who came out, Uche Maduagu, actually. You know him?
Yeah, I know him.
Yeah, the guy with the red bra.
Yeah.
That they were donating money to buy blue bra for him. Yeah, so what's your take on this one? Do you think it's a showbiz thing mm-hmm. for women to not be faithful, or, you know, would you marry in that space if you were not married?
No.
You never marry an actress?
Nah.
Why? What's the perception you have about actresses that, you know, you hear a lot out there?
Okay, let me put this way. I'm not saying I can't marry an actress. I can do that, but I have to be sure. I have to, like, be really sure. We have to understand each other. It's very important, both of us. I don't care what the world is saying, what people are saying, but me and my woman, we need to have that understanding. So I can actually marry an actress. So for this DNA thing and all that, I it's really scary. It's a very, very scary thing. I've heard lots of stories about it, and it's really, really scary. So it happens. It happens. And it's very, very difficult people to trust because of this whole thing. It's very, very difficult for people to get married to actress, but it happens. So I don't think, I just need that understanding with my woman before I can, you know.
So when you eventually have a child, which, you know, I can't wait for someone to call me uncle, you know. So when you eventually have a child, would you do anything like a DNA test to your wife?
No.
You wouldn't.
No.
You have that trust.
Yes.
So do you think it's a problem? Because recently we had the issue of paternity fraud, you know, mm-hmm. that came up recently, and then, you know, people were talking about a man who was even trying to get the kids to Canada and the whole family to Canada, and then they had to do one test or the other, and then he found out that his three kids were not his. Then that was when the whole paternity fraud thing came out, and he beat the woman right there at the airport or at the embassy or somewhere. I can't remember the story for facts now, but he beat up the woman, and people were saying, oh, why would you beat the woman? And people were like, well, if now you three children, you send them to school, you're even about to send them out of Nigeria, and then you realize that they're not your kids. So if it ever happens to you, what would you do? What would be your stand in that situation?
It's going to be crazy, heartbreaking, but they're my family already. I brought them up, you know, they grew up with me and all that, so there's nothing I can do about it. I will feel real pain, really hurts, you understand, but there's nothing I can do about it. I might end up maybe divorcing or separate, you know, but they're my kids. That's what I'm concerned.
Your
I
raise
them up, yeah.
Well, that's
but I will
that's,
never lay my hands on a woman, no matter what.
That's a lot of wisdom. That's a lot of wisdom. Yeah. So you don't think it's okay for, you know, you just being sure at a certain age, maybe when the child is like 10 years old and you're like, oh man, I need to do some DNA tests for my kids. You know, let's be sure.
I feel if you're connected to your woman, if you're connected, you know that if that's your kid, right from the start, you should know if that's your kid. I don't know. For me, I feel that everybody have their own opinion. Everyone have their way of life or something. But I feel if it's my kid, I will know. If the kid's out, when the kid is growing, I will know this is my kid. You should know that's your kid. So I don't think. It's just about the trust and understanding with your woman. Honestly.
Okay. I feel for you, it's not about, you know, the DNA. It's about the bond that you have created with your family. So it's not about, the child is for Mr. B or Mr. C. It's just that bond that you have with the kids, and that's what matters. So that's exactly what parenthood is, right?
That's what mostly matters. Mm. Yeah.
All right, amazing stuff. So let's get straight to it. We have another story. Nigerian singer Kelly Hansome has accused music mogul Don Jazzy of getting him arrested with men of the Special Anti-Robbery Squad, SARS. The music star made this known while reacting to Don Jazzy's recent interview with Ebuka on The Bounce, where he dared anyone to come out and accuse him of doing any wrong. I don't think there's anybody on the surface of the earth that would say this is what Don Jazzy did to me. Whether boyfriend, girlfriend, I would just say this is what I did. I go out of my way, ask the people close to me. I did take pains for people. Kelly Hansome countered the music mogul's statement as he accused him of getting him arrested a while ago. He wrote, "Did he also state, when he and his girlfriend arrested me with SARS and moved me from Kano to Abuja in handcuffs? No, he won't say that part, but it happened. Did he say when he sent his dogs to intimidate me and at Rexy Daminabo, Festus Keyamo is still alive?" He said, Don Jazzy is yet to react to Kelly Hansome's allegations. Mm-hmm. What's your take on this? There's this saying, he without sin, let him cast the first stone. Mm-hmm. And that was exactly what Don Jazzy did there. He said, I don't think there's anybody. I don't think I can come out and say anybody that I know. Because you don't even know when you're annoying people. You're doing the right thing. Mm-hmm. But somebody else will see it and be like, whoa, this guy went all out to do this to me. You understand? So I don't think I can come out and beat my chest. So I think that was a little bit too complacent on the part of Don Jazzy, if you ask me. Mm-hmm. And with, Kelly Hansome's reaction. But let me ask you, do you think you've done good by everyone you've met?
I don't think so. You know, we're humans. We have our own feelings. There's some certain times in life or certain stage in life that you might be going through something. Mm. You know, you're going through an emotional pee or something. So your reaction at that moment or your attention to a certain matter might be different at that moment. That might not be you, you understand? Mm. So. I don't know what happened between Don Jazzy and Kelly Hansome.
Did he tell us what he did?
Yeah, exactly. So I can't really judge. Yeah. You understand? Sometimes something happens and you just hear from one side of the story, you understand? So you can't really say, you understand? But if Don Jazzy went all in to arrest Kelly Hansome, I don't know. Nobody knows what happened. Nobody knows what Kelly
Hansome did. Did he deserve to be arrested?
I don't know. It's possible. I don't like that arrest P or arrest on, you know, but you don't know what happened. You don't know how deep it was, so you can't just judge, you understand? So
I like the fact you said that you don't like that arrest. What's the worst that anyone would do to you that you get them arrested, that you will have to use the police? Because I know you can use Rob Black Cartel.
If anybody messes with my family and maybe my money, I think I won't make everything legal. After trying to, you know, negotiate with you or try to, you know, be real with you and you're not coming through, then, you know, just take it today.
Alrighty. So, Kelly Hansome, you need to come out and tell us more. Tell us what transpired between yourself and Don Jazzy that for him to get you arrested, because we need to know. You can't just come and spring up or not. Now, Don Jazzy is with full confidence saying he has not offended anyone, and then you are coming out to say, so tell us exactly what you did and let us know if Don Jazzy is the guy. We have to do this gossip for you. Then please, can we at least do it well?
Yeah.
Anyways, we need to go on a music break, and myself and Black Beats will be right back. Yep. Stay with us.